And we're live, and we are now on a Rockhopper, and I'm going to drive a huge rock, which I've always wanted to drive around these places, not in time trial, but with other racers struggling with me to get to the first place. So I'm in a Patriot Thunderchief on a Rockhopper, finally! You can notice that this time I've took things a little bit further, and not only I've chosen a big rig where it normally shouldn't be, but I've also chosen a paint job which is not available to the player. But the method is pretty much the same, and I've said everything I wanted to say about it in that other video where I drive an Atlas Governor on a rain gap method. So if you want to know a bit about how to replicate this thing yourself, you should probably refer to that video. And here I'm just going to have some fun, and yeah, I aim to win this race. I waited for this for a long damn time. Gotta hold. You know, I actually like the music in the Monument Valley a bit more than that soundtrack they've got for the Pacific Rift. And I honestly sometimes just prefer to drive around these places. Pacific Rift is cool, but sometimes I just want to go to the desert. And it really bugs me why they haven't added some kind of DLC which will allow you to create custom races, some type of DLC recreation menu like they've had eventually in the Pacific Rift, because it really doesn't seem that hard. Oh man, that wolf bumped at me. Oh man, I wonder if the poor dude on the ATV alive. Oh, he's alive. Well, let's help him to change this. Oh man, come on, you can overtake me. Not when I'm on this track. Gotta hold my heart. Man, yeah, I really like Monument Valley. This feels good, this feels right. Oops, sorry. Actually, not that sorry, but just trying to be polite here. I'm pretty sure that if they wanted to add some kind of DLC that lets you create your quick races, so to say, I'm pretty sure they did it. I really do not know why. Yeah, that's a mystery. Let's try to take this jump. Ah! Yeah, oh man, cool. I usually do it on a rally car or a buggy or something, but it worked pretty much just as I've expected on a big rig. Alright, good. Let's now crush their party down there. Oh man, they're kind of far. Oh, they're fast here. Sorry. No, that's sorry. Oh, come on, who's that? Move it. Oh, this is something. Motorstorm is an awesome game. I mean, if you have a PS3 and you've missed it somehow, and if you're a fan of such games like Flatout and Burnout, you should definitely try, give Motorstorm a try. You most likely will like it, because it is just that kind of game, you know, this Flatout Burnout Motorstorm. It's like some kind of crazy trio of racing games which do everything just the way it should have been done for a long time. I mean, they're unbeatable. These three games are something else. Whoa. What really pains me is that all of those games are technically over. Flatout have been sold by Bugbear. Burnout have been ended as well. Also, the former Criterion guys, they make some kind of a spiritual successor. Akin to something akin how a Wreckfest is a spiritual successor to Burnout. And I must say, oh man, come on. And I must say, I haven't tried out a Wreckfest yet, but it is now finally released, and I made a mistake, but it looks like a good game. But still, I haven't tried it out yet. And Motorstorm, Evolution Studios got closed by Sony, and we can hope that somebody will... Goodbye, Lancia. Oh man, oh no, 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 he won't make it. Or will he? Alright. So Evolution Studios got closed by Sony, and somebody else can pick up the name. And honestly, it may be not a bad thing, because Arctic Edge have been made by big studios, and it definitely has the Motorstorm feeling in itself. I've played Arctic Edge and I've liked it. But only time will tell how it will turn out for Motorstorm, if it ever will. And meanwhile, we are first on a big rig on a Rockhopper. I'm definitely happy to drive this thing here. I think I'm gonna record another video too. Stay tuned. Thanks for being with me. Good luck.